Hi friends, on the eve of Jamai Shoshti, I'm going to make another yummy traditional Bengali recipe which is also very easy to make. So today I'm going to make borir jhaal or sun-dried lentil dumplings in rich, creamy coconut and poppy seeds gravy. So without further ado, let's see the ingredient list for this yummy Bengali recipe. First ingredient I have here is coconut milk. So I'm taking 1 cup of full cream coconut milk. And then I have 1/2 cup of poppy seeds with enough water and 6 green chilies to make a thick paste. I'll show the consistency here. See, pouring but thick consistency of poppy seeds paste. The next thing is lentil dumpling or borir. So I'm taking here motor daler borir or dried peas lentil dumplings. You can take any kind of borir, and this is how it looks like. Then I have 1 cup of mustard oil, which I'm going to use in 3 steps. And here I have 5 green chilies which are split longitudinally. Then I have salt as per taste. You can also add 1 to 1.5 teaspoon of sugar if you wish. And now in this wokol kadhai, I'm going to add 1/2 cup of oil, mustard oil. And also in this momo stand, I am going to keep water for boiling. And now I am going to add the borir or lentil dumplings, and I am going to fry them till they are brownish in color and also they are very crispy. And here we go, borir bhaja is now ready, or the fried lentil dumplings are now ready. So I am just taking them out in a separate bowl. And here we go, one step done. So the next step is add poppy seeds paste and coconut milk in this steel bowl which also has a lid. And now after mixing the two ingredients properly, I'm going to add salt, add sugar also in this step. If you are adding that, mix it properly till sugar melts, but here I'm not adding sugar. So now I'm going to add this borir bhaja and mix them properly so they are nicely coated. You can see the water content is very high, but don't worry, when we steam them it will be just perfect to be served. Now after adding mustard oil, now I'm going to add the green chilies, and I'm going to put the lid on. And in this momo stand where water is already boiling, I'm going to keep this bowl and put the lid on and wait for about 10 to 15 minutes here. And here we go. After 15 minutes, now I'm taking this bowl out, and now I will open the lid and show you how perfectly it's done. Now see, look at it. It looks so delicious, isn't it? And as I told you, all the water content is evaporated, and in this steam the borir are and the gravy is also now nicely steamed or boiled. And now I'm going to add the last bit of mustard oil, that is about 1 to 2 tablespoons of mustard oil. Mix it properly, give it a good stir, and our borir jhaal is ready. And here is the final look of the borir jhaal. See how scrumptious it looks like, and it tastes best with plain steamed rice, some extra green chilies, gondhoraj lebu, a slice of gondhoraj lebu, and some salt, and also water in this clay tumbler. In this way the water is very cool in the clay tumbler, and it tastes so delicious and so satisfying in this scorching summer heat. Friends, I hope you like this recipe. If so, then please hit the like button. Please subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon.